You can see we got a beautiful backdrop. Well, not beautiful, but handsome backdrop. And in the foreground, you can see there's a good coyote country. We just heard a coyote when we got out of the truck off in the distance. So we're gonna start with the Fox Pro with a little vocalizations, and then we're gonna go right into maybe a jackrabbit in distress or a cottontail. We're gonna go down here, look at the wind in our face, everything's perfect. So hopefully I'll get to fire my first arrow out of the air saber. So I better load this baby up. You ready, buddy? Sun's coming up, so we're gonna get down here in the shadows and get ready and make a call.
Will an arrow gun be enough to take out Wile E. Coyote? Well, we're about to answer the question. I'm in West Texas calling predators, but meanwhile, Sydney is back in Illinois. She's hunting whitetails on the final day of season. Sid and her buddy Dakota aren't too picky. For a mature buck or a fat doe will fit just fine in our freezer. And yep, that's a fat doe. Sid's got her Oneida bow locked and loaded with a deadly Carbon Express arrow. It's tipped with the evil Grim Reaper. That wide-eyed look on Sid's face is the "I'm about to let her fly" look. But she's got some brush in her way. The doe needs to step forward where she can get a good shot at the vitals. Okay, here we go.
I didn't want to wound her and have her just get through all the gizzards. No. Oh, there's the muscle. And finally, she moved one step and I moved my butt back. Slocked her.
This is a beautiful, mature white-tailed doe. Thanksgiving's tomorrow. She's going to be great on a platter. We're going to serve her up. Oh, we're going to eat our loins tonight. I'm going to field dress her right here, and we're going to take her home and get her ready for Thanksgiving meal tomorrow. Perfect shot. Couldn't have had it worked any better. I was getting a little nervous, because as you can see, there's a bunch of brush, and the wind was swirling all night long, so she was kind of skeptical to move any further down, and perfect shot. Pretty happy. All right, let's get her out. Kind of.
So Sid whipped out the cold steel knife, and sure enough, cut out the doe's gizzard. She left all the intestines in the forest, and the next day, Dakota and Clint were back, hoping that a coyote has found the bait.
Lousy. That's pretty cool. Came right up in.
sort of staring at the speaker. That was his last hunt.
So I decided to go to the old coyote sanctuary today because my son's a non-believer. But we got a coyote finally. It might have been a lucky day for us because it's warm and deer season just closed yesterday, which means there's gut piles everywhere, but we got one taker.
Dakota's a cop, but now he's training to be a game warden, so we're breaking him in right. He's killing the bad guys today.
Predator takedown number one.
There's the tree stand I fell out of. That was a bad day for me.
So now I'm 1,000 miles south, and I'm hoping to send an arrow at old Wiley myself. Just take a look at it. It's an arrow gun. Deadly arrows propelled by air. Much like a pellet gun.
The arrow goes right over the top of the cylinder inside there. That you're seated and loaded. I shoot Grim Reapers when I hunt with it, or I will. You can use any kind of broadhead that can withstand fast speeds, obviously. Then to load her and go live, cock her back like that. Pretty much like a high-powered rifle. Let's see how she does. I'm gonna take a shot at that white spot on the morel target. Yeah, buddy. I even held on the top edge thinking that 25 yards it might drop a little because it's sighted in at 20, but she's fast and it hit right where I was aiming. So let's take another shot. Basically. All right, I'm gonna hold dead center now, see how she does. Beautiful. Wow. Well, I was about to quit, but what the heck? Might as well take a shot at my bear out there. Let's give her a whirl.
Now all I need is a shot at old Wiley himself.
Well, it's not every day that you see a big male Texas coyote get slocked by an arrow gun. Matter of fact, that might be the first in history, but it was pretty impressive. I tell you, this gun did its job. My heart was pounding. I was pretty confident when he came up through there, but I was still in question because I'm trying something I've never done before. And the old air saber delivered death, dropped him in his tracks. I slocked him right through the beaner. And man, that was a rush. It drove that 2-inch Grim Reaper in one side, looks like in the eye, and right out the back of his head. Let's go check this coyote out. It's pretty awesome. Spectacular. Fantastic. What a beautiful coyote, too. My goodness, what a beautiful critter. He almost got away. He come running in here, and I had to call upwind of me, but I
I know when he turned and looked at Scott and I, it was probably curtains for him or he was gonna get away. So I just squeezed her off right on his chin, shot him a little high and put it right between his eyes. Pretty neat. What do you think, Scott? Huh, buddy?
I'm impressed.
Wow. Scott had his big gun all ready to back me up, but there was no need. He didn't even flop, did he?
No, he was dead right there.
Yeah. Well, you know, if you watch Relentless Pursuit, I'm not one of those product guys that's trying to stick stuff down your neck, but if you ever want to try something that's really cool, for under 500 bucks, all the bells and whistles, here it is, man. Umarex's Air Saber. What a fun gun. And that's the first arrow we fired at an animal. What do you think, man?
That's true.
From the looks of it, it drove that big Grim Reaper, that 2-incher, through all that bone and flesh. We won't have any problems with a hog.
No, I think...
You can cake this home with you, Scott. It'd be good for home defense.